they do throw a lot of wrinkles at you. You've got to be ready if you're Ohio State.
Well, this game's still there for the taking by either team. Largest lead was that of Ohio State by 11. 10 on the shot clock. Evan Turner. Screen from Lauderdale. There's the switch, the spin, and the jump shot. Not good. Here comes Ronald Moore. He's a Jet.
Oh, look at those hands. He stepped out of bounds. That's a good call.
Yeah, it sure is.
Nice play by Hill, though. Wow. Guy coming at you like that. That's when you call in help. Mommy dearest.
41-37. Overwhelming rebounding edge for Siena in this game. But they've hit only 30% of their shots.
Nice play there by Brassiter. Caught the ball. He knew the trap was coming. And they talked about it. Got it right out of that corner, of the corner. Harm's way.
Underneath. The dish. Rossiter. Two-point game.
Nice interior pass by Franklin. But they're right back at it.
Ronald Moore urging the crowd up, and maybe 10% of this crowd is dressed in green and gold, and Ronald Moore filled with emotion after the turnover.
They may be filled with something else. Backcourt and a turnover. Wow. And Vern, what happened here is Hill throws the ball, but Deeb was trying to get backcourt to help him. He was too impatient, and Thad Mata, livid, furious. Anybody who's been in this business has been there. Trying to get their attention and get them involved in this.
For the tie, no. Diebler with the rebound. Midway point, second half. A berth against Louisville on Sunday awaits the winner of this one.
And then this game makes a gentle soul ballistic at times, right?
Buford looks inside for Turner. Now kick it out. Diebler hasn't hit one yet.
Boy.
Still draws the donut. Lauderdale loses it. But it will be Ohio State basketball and an exasperated John Diebler.
How about that? He just smacked his hands together. He's just got to chill, relax. You'll get some more opportunities.
Diebler 0 for 7. Rossiter out on Turner. DJ Hill for 3.
God, does that help? A nice reversal by Diebler.
Defensively. He's an active one, isn't he?
Well, he's quick.
Ubelis. Down and out.
I believe people are involved in that one, if I'm not mistaken. How about this extra look, Brandon? A lot of people think he's going to shoot it. Gives a terrific opportunity for a step into the shot by Hill.
And Rossiter at the line. 2 for 2 tonight. The only lead Siena has had was 3-2.
That was quite a while ago. Needless to say, but Ryan Rossiter is just a solid contributor in all aspects of the game. Some of them roll, some of them more effective in the box score as well. Two.
Buford back outside. Hill, Turner. Buford.
Tough shot. And they get the foul. And they give it to Hasbrook.
Friends and family are heading to Harper's Island for a celebration. What they don't know is that there's a killer among them. The mystery event premieres Thursday, April 9th on CBS. Buford, one more. A little better.
Yeah, first one was offline, wasn't it?
4-point game, 9-12, 9-11 to go. Ronald Moore has the ball in his hands. Now here's Hasbrook. Very quiet night offensively. Travel.
Wow. Tried to go between the defenders. Not really good judgment on his part. It's interesting. Hasbrook off his game, Diebler off his game.
Yes.
Whoever steps up might be the decider.
Here's Evan Turner, who is not off his game, except for that one. Here's Moore. Off the front rim. Okay, grabbed by Turner.
What coverage.
Buford. Pull up jumper, short. Rebound, Hasbrook.
They are coming at them now. Siena picking up the pace.
Lost it.
I think he lost it. Yep, the double. He killed himself with the bounce. Save it and get rid of it. All right here, once he bounces, he's dead.
You know they both want it.
Oh, yeah.
There's just an inability to grab it. Oh, bad pass. Steal. Here's Moore.
Well, their half-court trap has speeded them up and really negated some of the thrust of Ohio State.
Hill across the timeline. Travel.
Steps. Again, confusing them, not prepared, rattled. And Fran mixing it up has been extremely successful, McCaffrey.
Buckeyes have turned it over three times their last four possessions. And yet again, a chance now for Siena to tie or take the lead. 8:03 to go in the ball game. Ronald Moore. Hasbrook.
Again, huh?
Saved by P.J. Hill for the Buckeyes. Buford. Hasbrook goes for the steal. 7:45 remaining. Two-point game. Thank you, Greg. P.J. Hill has it now. Ohio State in a drought. They've got one field goal in the last 6 minutes and 30 seconds. Buford, and the drought continues. Hasbrook with a rebound. Yet again, a chance for Siena to tie or take the lead.
And that's what you can do if you're Hasbrook to help out. You know he's struggling. And now make good judgments on your shot or drive.
Ronald Moore looks left. Here's Ubelis, guarded by Diebler. He goes left, puts a body on him offense. Yeah, I think so.
You know, I think you're right, Brian. Yeah. He went into his lane. I thought he had an angle. Pretty alert right here, just like moving and taking a guy out. Pretty solid. Good piece of officiating.
That's three on Ubelis, 16 fouls now. So next trip will be the bonus, 1-1. Boy, they're doing some sloppy passing.
Yeah, you know, I would prefer speed dribble up to the line, keep a guy behind, then go over the top.
Under seven, Hill, Turner, Lauderdale, Roster prowling back there on the baseline and in the lane. Seven on the shot clock.
This is the guy that usually finds a hole. They got travels again. And Ted Motley just turned his head over there on the sideline. Remorseful, contrite, please.
Looks like it's a mess.
Say one for me while you're there.
Sometimes you can't look.
Tough.
19 turnovers for both teams. An aesthetic work of art, this is.
No, it is not. Now, this is one of those you slug it out, walk out with a win. That's what it's all about. Who cares if it's pretty or not?
Foul.
I think Hasbrook out there with the small changer. Always looking for a spark. And just the ability to get some timely goals, some interior passes. Franklin and Rossiter to combine. I think the uptick of the press turned the thing, got them back in it. Within hailing distance at two.
Evan Turner uses all of the iron and gets the ball to fall. One more.
Interesting, he was talking to Ryan Kersey maybe about somebody disconcerting him.
Off the front rim. Three-point ball game, six to go.
Oh, goodness.
And Hill is taken down. No call.
Wow.
The ultimate in incidental contact.
What a save by Moore as it turned out.
Moore comes left. There's the switch. Buford, now Hill back. Little pump fake. Ubilis. That's for three. Way off the mark.
Didn't hit anything. They got to shoot it.
Shot. One on the shot clock. Shot Violet. Clock violation. Right.
Wow. You know, it's interesting, Vern. They're not getting anything inside, and they had some success earlier getting touches on the box, interior passes. But now everything's on the perimeter.
This has been an enormous drought for Ohio State from the field. And yet they still lead by three. Well over 7 minutes since they got their last basket in this game.
This matchup has been terrific, too. Great communication skills by Siena. It has confused Ohio State.
Diebler.
Yes!
He's now 1 for 8. Hasbrook. It still won't drop for him.
Oh, they got to push off.
Careful. Lauderdale and Rossiter. And some words are being exchanged.
Well, you just got to hang tough for the moment, as Diebler did. This is the Rossiter. I think he thought he had the ball.
Yes.
Oh. But Diebler just mentally tough, conditioned, always stick in there, and he did.
Dallas Lauderdale at the line for Ohio State.
Shooting Lauderdale one. Shoots 1 and 1. Now, this has been a problem area for Lauderdale.
Yeah, he's under 50 at 46. He has more stops than the local bus.
I don't mean to make fun of that's very descriptive. 4:40 remaining, 49-43. Screen from Franklin. Hasbrook pull up jumper.
There
yes.
You go. This kid's got a talent. And that time, they're taking advantage, just not settling deep.
Buford, there's the trap. This is Evan Turner. They'll reload. 4:10 to go. And a 4-point margin.
I think Turner and Buford have to keep active, particularly on the baseline. Nice screen by Lauderdale to get the open look here.
Oh, no. Deeper's now 1 for 9. Hasbrook. Up and under is good.
What a nice job by Franklin on that baseline.
3:40 remaining, a spot against Louisville in the waiting for one of these teams. And a 2-point game, 3:30 to go. Sloppily played, but aggressively contested.
Trying to ISO now Turner.
Buford goes left. Beauty, but he can't get it to drop.
And look who's there. Rossiter stepped in, and then Franklin cleans the glass.
At 1 point, Siena trailed by 11. Their only lead of the ball game was 3-2. And they've got a chance to tie or grab the lead right now with 3 minutes remaining.
Nice pass.
Rossiter, we're tied!
They had gotten away from the inside game. The high-low, gorgeous impact.
First tie since it was 8-8. And Siena has come from 11 down to notch it.
Ooh.
Jumper Turner, yes.
Big time delivery. Stepping up large.
2.5 to go, Buckeyes by a deuce. Ubilis. Moore for three. Lauderdale over the back to grab the rebound.
Rossiter looked like he was hurt, too.
Very slow and limping. And in pain as he comes across.
Ooh.
Reach in, foul on Moore.
I think they're going to go the other way on Hasbrook. What a great setup, and a Moore ready to steal and go the other way with the pilfer. A big time player step up. Nylon by the race, drilling it.
2:06 to go, 2-point Ohio State lead. Siena with three timeouts remaining. Buckeyes have two. Team fouls are 9 and 8, and the possession arrow looks toward Ohio State.
Evan Turner at the line for the Ohio State Buckeyes.
Evan Turner just hit a jumper to break a 49-all tie, and he is at the line. He's 3 of 4 tonight.
Well, he stayed there a long time prior to Siena coming out. Those guys wait and then step in.
One more. Well, he's using all the rim, but he gets it to fall twice. 4-point game. Siena's only lead of the ball game was 3-2. They fought back from 11 down to tie it, but the last four have gone to Ohio State. The rebound is up and good.
Up as that Ubelis. They had a set play. Hasbrook with the little bounce and jumper, and then weak side rebound. Terrific.
Evan Turner gets it across the hands of P.J. Hill. Here's Turner from behind. Ronald Moore.
Reading the shot, so important for an offensive rebounder. Anticipating where the ball is going to carom on and two. Just an excellent anticipation by Ubelis.
Tampa team foul, double bonus for the duration. Turner shoots a couple. That looked a little cleaner. Well, Turner has had a terrific year as a sophomore for Ohio State and has played very well in this one.
All league, and a lot of people thought he should have made player of the year, you know?
Yep.
Lucas, of course, great choice as well.
Turner has 18. Hasbrook, tough night for him.
Oh no, we got a piece, got a piece, got a break, got a break. You know, it's interesting, they had the high low going a little while ago. Maybe they can go back to that, slip somebody in the foul area, and then you can look low or wing it.
1:25 remaining. Winner gets Louisville on Sunday in Dayton.
And there's the nickel dimer. Louisville with their hands. Anytime you put two in there, you pay for it.
Buckeyes foul number 33, John Deeper.
John Deeper, who has had an equally tough night offensively, 1 of 9. And so Kenny Hasbrook is at the line. He's 1 of 2 on the evening. One and one. He gets another. That's the 9th team foul. Ooh. Buford with the rebound, almost taken away.
And they got a foul. Wow, I think that should have been.
Rossiter thought it was a hell ball. So did Hasbrook.
And so did I.
just to complete the trio.
Wow. Well, three for guy beats two pair. Wow.
And that is the 4th foul on Kenny Hasbrook.
William Buford at the line shooting.
Buford at the line. And he is an outstanding free throw shooter for the season, 88%. But tonight, 1 of 2.
Outstanding prospect, too.
1 of 3.
Checking in for the Buckeyes, Dallas.
Lauderdale on, Mullins out for the Buckeyes. Four-point margin, 1:18 to go.
Can Moore get in the lane? That's to me, one of the big things they've been able to prevent Ohio State.
Buford, nice job defensively on Hasbrook. Now P.J. Hill on it. Franklin, Lauderdale guards him, alters the shot. Turner was there as well, and here's P.J. Hill. 1 minute to go, 4-point Buckeye lead.
And that was a great job by Lauderdale. They get to reach in here.
That Monica calls timeout.
Wow. Lauderdale with great defense. Helped Ohio State.
Siena still with three timeouts. You see Ohio State has one remaining. They do have the possession arrow, and they have a four-point lead at the line tonight, 13 of 17 for Ohio State.
And Vern, this is key now that you got your trap set, and whether they want to give it or not, I might just guard and keep trapping to see if you can come up with a turnover. Ohio State has not been good with the basketball. And they got Ubilis on the ball and taking away the vision of Hill. Let's see how they handle it.
Ohio State has turned it over 19 times, topped by Siena's 20. 56.2 on the clock. P.J. Hill, Ubilis guarding the inbound play. Mullins is fouled.
And no question, they're going to give it right away.
Yep. So Rossiter picks up the foul, and that's going to send Mullins to the line.
Siena fouls on number 22.
Mullins not a great free throw shooter either. And it's interesting, pretty good coaching. You get it passed to a guy around 56%.
Yeah.
And everybody else, they sort of put the vacuum on.
For the season, 56% tonight, perfect. This is his third trip. Not perfect. One more.
Well, this kid learns the game. He's going to be terrific. Showed a couple things early in the game offensively that you usually see those jams on in his game.
For two. 4-point margin. Moore in the corner. Hasbrook.
Yes! Oh, Moore with the speed dribble. And Hasbrook, well, when you've been around, you got the confidence to persevere. It's all about life. Drill it, Mr. Hasbrook.
Man, everything on the everyday value menu is only a buck.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
pretty
yeah.
Awesome. What's going on here, by the way?
Oh, I had the hoops injury. I had ice.
Oh, really?
You know, we got that universal remote now.
Yeah.
It's, I don't know, way longer. And I was trying to switch between basketball games, and I just felt something just tearing there.
Okay, so you were watching basketball.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Game day food. Sonic's everyday value menu has the tasty food fans crave, like a junior deluxe burger or a junior Fritos chili cheese wrap, all for just a dollar each.
56-55, and Ohio State having problems at the line here at the finish, one of their last four. Siena now has two timeouts left. Ohio State won, and it's a 56-55 game with 47 seconds to go. Again, a reminder, just a quick one, Siena's only lead tonight was at 3-2.
And they've had trouble against this trap. You've got to step to the ball, make sharp passes.
Hill into Diebler's hands. Now P.J. Hill, here's Ubilis out to defending.
You just want to play solid.
Half a minute to go. Diebler and Turner. 10 on the shot clock. Screen from Mullins. Turner, 5 on the shot clock. Tough shot.
A great defense.
Siena with a chance for the lead. Ronald Moore. Hasbrook way up and out.
Wow, I think it was Turner on the foul. How about the ability of Moore twice now to push the ball up the floor and give his teammate an opportunity to knock some shots down. 67%, and this crawler almost goes for a chance for a three. And how about this? Oh, the body English working it in there.
Kenny Hasbrook, the senior from Capitol Heights, Maryland, at the line. His team trailing by one. He shoots two. His dad, Jeremy, his mom, Deborah, watching from the corner of the arena. Jeffrey Hasbrook. This one for the tie.
Ohio State with some options now. Depending on what happens, they got the one timeout to play with.
This one for the tie.
There you go. Way to stick it. Always root for the kid.
Timeout, Siena. Placid response. We've been tied in this ball game twice. 8-8,
three times, 8-8, 49-49. And now, both teams, one timeout left. Both teams in the double bonus and possession arrow, Ohio State.
And for this trap, this three-quarter court trap, if they go over the top, somebody can get free for an open jump shot. So they better cover the area. Diebler going wide. Quick push.
Evan Turner has it. 4 seconds to go. Turner off the glass, no good. P.J. Hill at the buzzer. Overtime.
Oh. How about that? Is this heated up beautifully? Turner trying to do it all off the bounce. Pretty good collection defensively. And the last line again, the bang by Rossiter probably threw him off. And Hill with the quick jack at the end of that. Whew. What a day. Huh? Let's go. Five more, Vern.
Seems appropriate that on a terrific day of basketball here in Dayton, Ohio, we go to overtime, Siena and Ohio State. The winner gets Louisville on Sunday. Top-seeded Louisville, they had trouble in the first half with Morehead State, but outlasted them. And in the other part of the region, games being played down in Miami. Mullins and Franklin. And it's controlled by Hasbrook.
And Vern, Siena now has Hasbrook's head in the game. He's a little more comfortable. Ohio State needs Diebler now. If they penetrate and find him, he's got to convert to help that club.
Hasbrook.
How about this?
First lead since they were up 3-2.
And boy, the Swiss cheese D there for the first time in a penetration.
Watch out. Oh, they were close to over and back, and then Hill comes up and grabs the pass. First lead for the Saints since they were up 3-2 at the 18-25 mark, opening moments of the game.
Trying to flare for Diebler. We'll see if Mullen can do some damage on the block.
Hill.
Yeah, there you go. Oh, he didn't seal it, Mullen.
Saints. Moore. Hasbrook puts it on the floor this time. Back outside to Ronald Moore.
Boy, new attitude by Hasbrook, though. He's got a little spark going. Mullins has got a rebound now. Make sure.
Alex Franklin. Ubilis for three. And Diebler with a rebound. Gives it quickly to Hill. At the other end, Buford. Jumper.
Look who's there.
Hill.
They got him a push off.
Yes.
You wonder why he was that wide open, right? The little guy. A little tavern discard. This is a floater that Buford normally makes, and you can just see the ride out by Mullins. Just check this out. You got Hill first, then Mullins second. They both got him. How about that?
And so Rossiter goes to the line at the other end, shooting two. He's perfect tonight. 4 of 4.
77%. Kid is so solid. Understands the game. Looks like he's got that affinity to be a coach because he understands what contributions you can make and help a team win.
Rossiter shoots one more.
And he gets a freebie here, too, if he wants. He didn't need it.
Buford was in the lane, but he cans it. So still perfect for the night. And Siena, they knocked off Vanderbilt last year, first-round game. And they are very much in this one now, up by 4.
And his three-quarter court press has been the deterrent in this matchup as well.
P.J. Hill from Diebler. Turner. Diebler. There you go.
That's what they need.
Yep.
They need it to light it up.
That's his second three of the night. He's 2 for 10. Moore.
Tough shot. Great D by Hill.
Lauderdale gets it back to Hill. Foul in the backcourt on Rossiter. That's his fourth. And so we will march to the other end of the court.
And that one he needed, really. More of a fatigue deal. But just a great kick out there. Turner with that ISO that gets a pinch post pass. And right here, trying to give a little bit extra, just got caught behind.
DJ Hill at the line, 2 for 2 tonight. Rossiter picks up his fourth. This is for the tie.
Fun to work overtime, isn't it? I don't know if the coaches have enjoyed it.
Well, you are a master of it. I seem to recall hearing you on a UConn-Syracuse game recently.
Well, that was incredible.
6 overtimes in that one.
How good was that one?
Ohio State leads by 1. Rossiter wants it.
And don't forget that little high-low. Flash and dump down. And there's the flash.
Into the corner, 2:42 to go. Ronald Moore, now Buford's on it.
And Yulman's nice job getting free.
No roll, tip, controlled by Evan Turner. P.J. Hill walks it up.
And Renee like to give it to Turner, and he isos on one guy against this matchup.
Buford. Turner again.
That's his job.
Splits
right there.
Loves it. Kicks it. Buford. Rebound. Siena. Ronald Moore. Boy, he doesn't walk it up at all. Here's Hasbrook. P.J. Hill's out there. Ronald Moore. Bounce pass. Rossiter. The dish to Ubelis. No. Foul.
They got foul on the side of the head. Boy, they are moving. Quickly cutting well, making some better decisions.
That puts Edwin Ubelis at the line. Fourth foul on Buford, 2 shots for Ubelis. 63% free throw shooter over the season.
But again, it does give you a lot of things to think about on that defensive end. Puts a lot of pressure on your guards and your decision makers.
Perfect. Siena by 1. 1:50 to go. Hill, Turner, Diebler, Buford, and Lauderdale on the floor for Ohio State.
They got a nice trap. They can step up now. They got the timeout. Oh, weren't ready.
Thad Mata calls the time, 1:40 to go, Siena by 1. Time to catch our breath.
Well, I'll say a lot of action's been going on. A lot of decisions to be made, particularly Ohio State has. How do you want to attack this match?
To take the last
17 seconds to play there. Let's go back to Dayton.
It's out of bounds by...
I think it's going to stay there.
Yep.
I think they said Hasbrook was stepping on the line. But it's so important to get the rebound in this kind of a situation. Look who's in the mix of it, too. Nice hands by Hasbrook. Saved it from Turner.
Pretty Mullins, play. Yes!
What a screen and setup. And a big fella knocking it down.
Buckeyes by 1. One minute to go. Hasbrook.
Oh, nice hands by Hill.
P.J. Hill, yes it was. On the floor, saved by Buford. Here's Hill, guarded by Ronald Moore.
Just play straight up now. Get your stop. That's what you want if you're Siena. Conversely, run some clock.
Deeper in the corner, looks inside for Mullins. Turner, 2 on the shot clock. Pull-up jumper. Off the front rim. Rebound saved by Mullins.
Big time effort. That's what he was there for. Wow. The little things that win ball games, Vern. The step back jumper. Mullins got himself in position. But that little screen that set it up earlier. Great call by Thad Mata. The little curl, and then the big fella gets in the proper position. Look at that full extension. And now the presence of mind to recover and find his teammate. Terrific.
Timeout, Siena, with 9.1 remaining. Mm. 9.1, Ohio State with the ball and a one-point lead after that huge save by B.J. Mullins.
And, of course, now with the free throw opportunities, you make them 1-2, then you decide what you want to do at the other end. There's plenty of time, 9 seconds to go, going the other way. Now, these kids are so well-schooled in their lifetime in these crunch situations.
Both teams in the double bonus, as you see, both with one timeout remaining. And that possession arrow hasn't changed in the last 7 or 8 minutes. 63-62, Mullins on the out-of-bounds play with that nice, soft shot. And then the huge save on the rebound when he jumped out of bounds and knocked it back in play.
How many practices have we been at, Vern, where, you know, they run nice little spin out by Mullins. You'll see them go through their practice, and it's a ritual. And all of a sudden, it becomes a key play in a key situation in the game when executed properly. Hill now at 68%. He will dictate what he's trying to do at the other end. Shooting them pretty good, huh?
Yes, 4 of 4 tonight. I bet it's times like this you miss coaching.
Well, you do. I mean, the excitement, the decision-making, the response of players. I think at a certain age, it gets a little harder, though, to be honest with you.
Hill with one more.
Top time. On the free throws.
9.1.
Got to get.
Hasbrook heads to the right corner. The jumper from Moore.
Oh, yes!
Wow! 2 to go. Here's Diebler, pump fake at the buzzer. No!
How good is it? How good is it? Oh. Guys, step it up.
They're
going to have to go run it up and down.
Lauderdale and Franklin will jump for the tip. It's controlled again by Franklin. Boy, he's got some serious elevation.
And quickly, doesn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, yeah. First double overtime game since 2007. Vanderbilt, Washington State involved in that one. Rossiter back outside. Hasbrook traveling.
Wow, tough one.
22 Siena turnovers.
And a good job by Diebler to cause that problem. Once again, that 1-2-2, harassing. Not a good spot to pick the
jump. Wow!
Look at this. And they got a freebie underneath.
Tip out of bounds. Got away with one.
Wow. And the judgment has to prevail. Not a good job attacking.
So Buford will throw it in and finds P.J. Hill. Turner.
There's that iso they like. A disadvantage defensively.
Chased down and saved by Hasbrook. Now here's Ronald Moore, cornered, Ubilis. Back to Hasbrook.
Nice cut.
Ubilis with a pump fake. And there is a foul on the play that's going to send Ubilis to the free throw line. Foul is on Turner. That's his third.
And Vernet done a nice job mixing up the look, whether it's the dribble drive or the cut right up the lane. Pump fake gets him to the rim. Didn't ward off at all. Tendency is to get that free arm out there.
Ubilis shoots 2, 5 of 6 tonight.
Really some toughness on both sides coming down the stretch here.
One of two.
How about that?
Rossiter.
And Franklin's the one that got it to him. Keeping it alive.
Siena by one. Huge disparity in the crowd here because of the proximity of Dayton to Columbus and the difficulty in traveling from Siena. I would say only 10% of the group in here are Siena fans trying to make themselves heard. And Franklin, no. Foul.
And I think they give it to Turner, but what a cut again. It's really interesting how they've changed. Is that 4, Verna?
Yes.
Wow. And the understanding of when to get into the lane, that's just terrific. Able to get the contact, get to the free throw line. That's twice now, right in the gut.
Alex Franklin. One more.
Turner with four fouls. Siena with a three-point lead.
Not looking over the top, though. Frank.
No. Again. Now Buford, Rossiter. Here's Turner.
I got to get back in there, Rossiter. He's losing himself. No, same way.
He's seeing a little sense of weariness.
Yeah, right then.
Yes.
And no coverage after the trap.
Right.
You know, the legs do go. Mulligan's back in. Terrific finish in the last overtime.
B.J. Mullins back in for Lauderdale. 68-65, 3:29 to go, second overtime. Here's Turner. Mullins in the lane. Jumper, Buford, no.
And you know, why not give it to Mullins? He was wide open. He's got that little hook.
Ronald Moore has the ball in his hands. Hero of the first overtime with his jumper, 4-3 with 2.5 seconds to go. Tied it up. Here's Ubilis.
Smart play here. Still trying to run some stuff. Less than 10.
Ubilis. Five on the shot clock. Left-handed shot. Oh,
what a save.
Offensive board. Hasbrook.
Didn't need it, really.
B.J. Mullins. Great anticipation.
Could have given it to Moore and run some clock again.
I just get a little sense of weariness now on both teams.
I agree, and why not pound it inside? Roster a little fatigued, but Mullins out there for the flare screen.
Turner, jumper.
Yes, and really not a challenge by Ubilis. Didn't really get up on him. They're going to check and see, I believe, if it's a two or a three.
And they will look at the monitor.
The referee's eyes may be weary at this point, and rightfully so. They've done a nice job. This has been a tough game.
Oh, ooh.
Close, little, little toesy.
Very quiet
he's
here.
Gonna have to get a, he's going to have to get a mani-pedi to make sure this one counts.
Boy, well, we'll try and blow this up, figuratively.
Having a tough time deciding that.
Yeah.
Right there, it looks like it's on it, but
I'm not sure. It was called a two.
Well, then they'll stick with it if they're not sure.
You think?
Not. If it's inconclusive, they'll go with their call. That's why they're asked to always make a call, Vern.
A little head scratch.
Yeah, you know you're in trouble when the ref scratches his head, huh?
Now that looks like it's a three.
Now that looks okay. Now let's see if he just nudges for
22 to play in overtime. He'll make his move now with seven, with six. There's that killer crossover, backs it out for three. Bangs it off the rim, rebound, Wisconsin. That ball is in the hands of Bohannon, timeout. Bohannon hit that shot, but Bo Ryan called timeout.
So while Wisconsin thinks about it during a timeout, we'll take you back to Dayton, Ohio. They're tied at 68.
Well, they did look at the replay. They would call it a two, but it was clear that Turner's foot was behind the line, so a three-point shot has tied it up. 1:50 to go, second overtime. Lauderdale there defensively. P.J. Hill tries to save it. Goes to Moore.
He's got
to
shoot it, though.
Shot clock violation. Wow.
Wow. Oh, wait, they're going to check.
Hill, a little painful arisal when he gets up.
No, I don't think it hit. Yeah, that's one of the, I don't think that hit. No,
it
no
did
question
not.
Whatsoever. Here they go again.
Let's go back to the monitor.
Well, that was a little more peaceful than earlier.
Yeah. Well, silence seems the only option here. They're going to look. Here comes a Mike Kitts is going to let us know. Okay, Mike Kitts, that's great that they take the time to come over and help us.
Yeah, it really is. They're going to see if Hill had possession, which then would put a new shot clock situation in. You follow?
Yes.
Yeah. So you're right. It's so much nicer to. It definitely didn't hit the rim. Now, does he have control? That's still.
Boy,
that's tough to say he had it. Boy, when he fell out of bounds. Was his foot out of bounds?
Yes.
Major dilemma. They're gonna give him time over there.
That looked like the decision.
2 seconds.
Two seconds. I believe that's what I saw.
And it'll be Siena's ball. But now, Vern, I'm asking though, Vern. Let's see where if he's out of bounds. Yeah, I guess he wasn't, but the ball should be further down.
51-59, Wisconsin, 2 seconds to play. Let's go back to Dayton. They're tied at 70.
I don't even know. Maybe, I don't know. This was just a terrific cut to get the deuce by Ubilis.
Ronald Moore at the line, first time tonight. One more.
It wasn't so much the two hands as couldn't they be seen from where the call was made. You know what I mean?
Timeout, Siena. So Siena retakes the lead. Thad Mata more than just a little this week.
And Badgers live to fight another day. That day will be Sunday. Let's take you back to Dayton. 71-70, Siena.
71-70, Perner.
Ooh.
Hill.
Oh, Asberg had the read. Mullins the key guy, I think, on offensive rebound. Look at this post
up. Mullins is there. Turner off the glass and good.
That kid just takes over. Priceless.
Buckeyes by one. Ronald Moore saves Siena in the first overtime.
Letting them play.
Ubilis, 7 seconds to go. Three-pointer.
Oh! Hudgens! Double order!
For the second time in the second overtime, Ronald Moore cans a three.
Garden variety, the little guy knocking him down big time. Vern, just magnificent how kids can step up. Ubilis gets two people to gather, kicks it, and this little guy just magnificent. The choreographer of the club gets everybody involved and stepping up, coming down the stretch. And Ohio State has that one timeout to play with, Vern, so they can get it to half court. And they only need a deuce.
How about Ronald Moore? 0 for 4 from 3. And then with 2.5 left in the first overtime, he cans a 3 to tie the score. With 3.9 in the second overtime, he gives Siena the lead. Back to Turner. Jumper. Ooh. At the buzzer, Siena wins.
Final score, Siena 74, Ohio State 72.
Joy and shock at the same time in this building, don't you think?
Absolutely.
Mom and Dad having a ball.
Jeffrey Hasbrook, Deborah Hasbrook. They've come a long way to watch their son and his teammates play. Here is the final shot of the game. It is a tiny but vociferous crowd here to cheer on the Saints of Siena. My goodness.
How good has this kid been for this program? Draw two and kick a little nylon by the little guy.
Louisville and Siena will meet here on Sunday. The ninth seed against the top seed, Ronald Moore, two huge three-point shots. One in the first, one in the second overtime, provides the winner 74-72. Siena advances to take on the Cardinals. Greg Gumbel after these words.